my name is Jean from the Moldlab. Today I'll be showing you how to take mold samples using our airborne mold test kit. So the kit will have two extra just-in-case air cassettes, three sample collection cassettes, a pump, and a clear tubing. The three sample collection cassettes are what you'll use to collect your samples. It comes in a bag with our pamphlet. If you need more than three sample collection cassettes, we have included two just-in-case cassettes labeled with a blue sticker for an additional cost. This is what our pamphlet looks like. It has the instructions on how to take the mold samples. If you flip the pamphlet over, you'll see the sample submittal form. Please have all the information filled out and have it sent back along with your samples. And last but not least, the back of the pamphlet has information on the pump number and its calibration date. So now let's get started on how to take some samples. First, fill out your information on the submittal form. Make sure to have sample number and location labeled on both the cassette and on the form. We ask that everyone take an outdoor sample to help serve as a reference for data comparison. Next, we need to peel off the stickers on both ends of the cassette. And then we'll connect the tube to the cassette. Make sure the tube is attached inside the circular part of the cassette. Go ahead and plug the pump into an outlet. Make sure the flow rate of the pump meter is at 15. If it's not, you can adjust the flow rate on the meter by turning the black knob on the top. Make sure to have the timer set to 10 minutes. Turn on the pump and start the timer. When your 10 minutes is up, stop the pump and make sure to record the start time and stop time on the pamphlet. This allows us to give you the most accurate mold concentration at a given location. Do the same thing for your other two locations. As an example, this is what your form should look like after you've taken all three samples. If you do use the two just-in-case cassettes, make sure to add in the sample information on your pamphlet as well. When you are ready to mail the samples back to Moldlab, place the pump back inside the box. Place your samples inside the bag along with your pamphlet and put them in the box. Make sure to place a return label on the box and return the kit to Moldlab by the date specified on the green sticker. Last but not least, special thanks to my coworker Steven for allowing me to use his hands for this video.